Are you really the same person you say you are? Or is someone impersonating you over the phone? The soft-spoken gentleman from Jane's SR asked me. I closed my eyes. When I was 6 years old, I got affected with severe fever that impacted my brain nerves. Overnight, I got very high power in the eyes and I began to lose my ability to hear. The hearing loss was so slow and gradual that no doctor could detect it. It was only when I was 15 years old that the doctor diagnosed it as a sensory neural hearing loss, and he told me I lip read. Because I used to sit on the first bench in school, I had begun the art of lip reading on my own without even being aware that I'm lip reading. My life changed overnight. The next day, I went to school with two hearing aids, and the whole school principal, everyone stopped to look at me. But ironically, my grades began to get better after the onset of my disability, and I got admission to undergraduate course in engineering on merit. College is supposed to be fun. You learn, you fall in love, you make friends. College for me was a nightmare. In a class of nearly 80 students, I struggled to lip-read my professors. I couldn't follow a word of what they spoke. And in my class, the first row was occupied by 13 girls. The second row was left blank out of modesty. And then in the third row, me and other boys sat. It was impossible to follow from the third row. Accessible and inclusive education, it wasn't a thing back then. From being a rank holder in school to getting an F in a college subject, my life went downhill. I lost my confidence, my self-esteem, and it was so desperate, so hopeless, that at one point I felt like ending my life. As I sat crying in the college campus, holding my mark sheet with an F, a hand tapped my shoulder gently, and there was a chit that read, "Sit next to me and copy notes from me." I looked behind to see my classmate. She was the university topper, and she asked me to sit next to her. I was delighted, but only for a fraction of a second, because sitting next to her would mean I need to sit with the girls. So the next day in college, I went and I sat in the middle of 13 girls. For a full 2 minutes, the whole class laughed. The girl also laughed. But those 2 minutes of laughter that I endured helped me to convert my F to an A. So the college, I passed with a first class, but who would give job to a person who cannot listen a word on the phone? So, from the western part of India, where I grew up, I went all the way to the southern part of India, in a different city, different culture, different language, different food habits. And there was a company that hired people with disabilities. The CEO of that company was a wonderful human being. And so I began my career there under a manager. And whatever I am today, I owe it to him. For the next 3 years, I learned a lot of programming languages. Under him, I learned the principles of software craftsmanship. And then it was time for me to go to a client's place. You see, for me, my first impressions are never good. And when I met the client for the first time, he was a Santa Claus-like man with a long, flowing beard. I couldn't even see the lips, let alone read the lips. He was super frustrated, but I persisted. And in 1 week, he became a wonderful friend. And 1 month later, I delivered the project ahead of time. So for the next couple of years, I delivered to multiple client places, delivering value and excellence. I was high on confidence, and after 6 years, I felt an itch that can I survive outside this company? So I made my profile, and I put my mobile number, and whenever I got a call, I would go to my friend who would talk on my behalf. And I got multiple calls, but not a single chance to attend an interview. So I hit upon a plan. In my profile, I put my friend's mobile number, and he pretended to be me. The hack worked. The calls began to get scheduled. And once this call came from James HR, the HR would call my friend who would pretend to be me, who would text me. The trick worked for a while until we were busted. And the HR came and said, "Are you really the same person you say you are, or is someone impersonating you over the phone?" And I said, "I have to find a way around this non-inclusive hiring system. You show me a better way." Since then, it has been 10 wonderful years for me in Gen, driving inclusion one cubicle at a time, to becoming a Pride LE, to launching an LGBTQ chapter, to finally launching a community for people with disabilities, and ensuring that they have accessible and inclusive education which they never got a chance to. I started contributing to open source, started speaking at meetups, technical meetups, and became an AWS community builder. So summing up, life isn't about how much you've fallen down. Life is about how you bounce back, how you raise yourself up, for life is what you make it. Thank you.